to day one of our Circus Holiday Club. We are really excited to have you with us. My name is Jess.
And I'm Pip, and we have got so much fun lined up for you over the next few days.
So I think, Pip, we should start off the way we're going to start off every morning, by making sure we're really warmed up and ready for some circus activities.
So we're going to warm our bodies up.
Warm up our bodies. Are you ready for our circus warm-up? Here we go.
Hi, my name is Debbie. Let's get warmed up. So let's go. Stretch as high as you can. High, reach up. Good. And now can you go wide, wide, legs wide. How far can you go? Keep stretching. And can you jog on the spot, on the spot? Go. As fast as you can, as fast as you can. Faster than me. And go round one side, the other side, and one hand. If you want to do it same time, the other hand, and legs. If you want to join everything, let's see. And the other legs, shake everything out. So, next piece, we're gonna imagine we're strumming with your feet shoulder width apart. Bend down, pick up your weights, and lean up high to your shoulder and press up. And come down, put it down gently, and put it down, yeah, again. Pick it up high, and push it down, hands down. And one more time, pick it up, and push it down. Great. We're gonna pretend like we're gonna be singing, so we wanna warm up our voices. I want you to roar like a lion to the right, and to the left, and forward. Oh, yeah, great job.
Good morning, Egbert. How lovely to see you.
Oh, hello, Jess.
Egbert, I'm not Jess. I'm Pip.
Oh, sorry. I'm very forgetful.
That's okay.
I will try and remember. Pip.
Yes, that's my name, and you're Egbert.
Oh, I know
that. So, how are you today? What's going on?
I'm not actually having a very good day.
Oh no, what's wrong today?
Well, you see, I got given a very special job by the ringmaster.
Oh, that sounds very important.
Yes, I was very excited, and I had all of these pieces of a very important sign to put up.
Right.
But you see, I dropped them on the floor, and now I can't remember what order they are supposed to go in.
Yes, I see them down there, the purple ones.
Yes, they are on purple paper.
Right, and so do you need some help then, Egbert? Can I help you?
Oh, I would love it if you could help me.
So I could pick up the sign, we could put them up on the board together.
Oh, yes, please, that would be very good.
Do you remember what the sign said? Because there's lots of words there.
I don't remember very much.
Okay.
Well, I think it started with a capital letter.
Okay, I can do that. Oh, here we go. I've got one that says, be strong.
Oh, yes, that sounds good.
Oh, hold on, I need something to stick it up with. Here we go.
Oh, really?
Be strong. That sounds like a good beginning of a sign. I'm going to pop it under your legs, just there.
Okay.
Be strong. Okay. What's next?
And something else. You have to be strong and something
and
else.
And something else. Okay. Be strong and brave.
Oh,
be strong
yes.
and brave.
That
Here we go.
Brave.
Be strong and brave. There's your next one. This sign's going to look great with the purple and blue. Be strong and brave. Now there's a full stop, so does that mean I'm looking for another capital letter?
Oh, yes, there were two sentences in it.
Okay, here we go. I've got don't. Don't be.
Don't be. Don't be.
Afraid?
Well, it's very good. I'm not afraid. I'm just a bit worried.
Okay, but this one says afraid.
Oh, I see.
Don't be afraid. I think that's a good way to start
don't
the sign.
Be afraid. What does it say so far?
So far it says be strong and brave.
Be strong
don't
and brave.
Be afraid.
Don't be afraid. Well, that sounds like it. That sounds very good.
There are quite a lot of other words on the floor.
Oh, there's more.
Yes. I think we probably want a because next. I think that's a good idea.
Yes, that's we'll like go, a joining word. Isn't it
is. We'll go, be strong and brave. Don't be afraid because the what, the who, the where. It's a who.
A who.
It's because the Lord, it says. Because the Lord your God.
Lord your God.
Stick that under you there. There we go. We're doing well.
Yes, we are doing very well. But you're doing a lot of the work, Pip.
Well, we're nearly there though, aren't we? We're working together as a team.
Yes.
It says, because the Lord your God will be with you.
Will be with me where?
Well, let's have a look. Aha, I can see. It says, wherever. That's the next one. We'll stick that on. Wherever you go.
Hooray!
Wherever you've got an exclamation mark on this one. Oh. Does that mean it's the end of the sentence?
That does sound like an ending one, doesn't it?
Yes.
Is that all of the words from the sign?
I can see one more on the floor, which is a very helpful one when you're learning a Bible verse.
Is it?
Yes, because it tells you where in the Bible you can find that verse.
And where in the Bible can we find this verse?
Well, this one's from a book called Joshua, and it's from chapter 1, verse 9.
Joshua 1, verse 9.
That's right. I'll pop that at the bottom there. And shall I read it all back to you?
Oh, yes, that would be very helpful.
See if this is how you remember it as well. Okay. It says, be strong and brave. Don't be afraid, because the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
Wherever you go.
Joshua, we need to do reference as well. Joshua 1 verse 9.
Joshua 1 verse 9.
Can you remember that?
I will try very hard, Pip.
Okay.
Shall we say it one more time together?
One more time together. Maybe at home you could read it along with us as well. Because
yes,
it's a good thing to do to be able to remember it, say it out loud. Let's go all together. Are you ready? One,
yes.
Two, three.
Be strong and brave. Don't be afraid, because the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Joshua 1 verse 9.
Good job, Ava.
Yay, I got it.
I think now you need to go and tell the ringmaster that you have done the sign.
Yes, I will tell him that you helped me as well.
That's lovely.
It was lovely to see you. Thank you for your help, everybody.
See you soon, Ava. Bye.
One of the things we love to do here at the circus is to sing and dance and celebrate together our amazing God. We're going to do that now, so stand up wherever you are and join in. You'll be able to watch us doing all the actions.
By my friend King Dave, wouldn't let the giant stand in his way. He said, hand me my sling, 'cause he's not that tall. My God is bigger and I watch him fall. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Have you heard the one about this guy called Dan? Yes, he was a mighty holy praying man. They said throw him to the den of the scary beast, but God saved a hero from the lion's teeth. Yeah! My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. History, you will do the same for me, like Jonah and the whale at sea. When I'm lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. Oh, you're with me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My
with me.
Today, I'm going to tell you a story all about a little boy whose name was David. Here we go. It starts with someone very big and a bit scary. Goliath was a mean giant. He was in an army that came to fight King Saul's army. "Bring out your best soldier to fight me," yelled Goliath. "If he wins, we will be your slaves." The king's men were scared. They did not want to fight the giant. David was a shepherd boy. He trusted God. His brothers were in the king's army. David took some food to his brothers. When David saw Goliath, he said, "He does not scare me." David told the king, "I can fight this giant." "You are too small," said King Saul. "I am not afraid. God will help me," said David. "Then you must wear my armour," said the king. It was big and heavy. "I cannot wear this," said David. David chose 5 stones. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. "Ha!" laughed the giant. "You cannot beat me." David said, "I come before you in the name of the Lord, who rules over everything." Whoosh! David let a stone fly. And wham! The stone hit Goliath's head. The giant fell to the ground and died. All the men in Goliath's army ran away. "God is great," shouted David, and the whole of the king's army cheered.
Hi boys and girls, I'm Dougie Doug Doug, and I'm so excited to be at the circus with you. And I know today you're making juggling balls and talking about David the Juggler. I thought, let's juggle, maybe do a few tricks. Let's throw one over the top. Yeah, over the top. And let's throw that same one over the top and back the other way. Over the top and back the other way. Cool. Now how about this? How about we throw them all over the top? Let's try that. Whoa, chaos. And this is a really hard trick. This is called Neil's Mess. Yeah. Whoa. Oh my goodness. All right, this is 2 in 1 hand. Let's add a third one in. Here we go. This is called cheating. And this is called trying to join the M25 first thing in the morning. Let me on, somebody, please. Thank you very much. This is up and down in the lift. This is up and down underneath the lift. Don't know why you do that. And this is a really weird one. This is up, cross, and down. And that is juggling. Woohoo! Today's story of David and Goliath is an incredible one. Now, juggling is obviously all about throwing and catching, and David was an expert at throwing things using his sling. Much better than me, I think. Oops. Ooh, that's not good. Definitely much better than me. David, the young shepherd boy, took on the fearsome giant Goliath, and he won. None of the soldiers, with all their training and all their armour, wanted to do it, but David did. Wow. But how is it possible that a young shepherd boy with no training and no armour could possibly defeat a monstrous giant like Goliath? Well, David said that God had rescued him when he'd had to wrestle lions and bears to save his sheep. And so he believed that God would help him defeat the giant. David trusted God. But can you even imagine wrestling a lion? They're so ferocious. My friend Chris is the head keeper at Noah's Ark Zoo Farm, and he kindly agreed to film some lions just for you guys. So check out the lions having their lunch. Amazing, eh? Amazing creatures. And I can tell you that I definitely would not want to wrestle one of those. David was a very brave young man who knew that God had helped him in some very tricky times. Now, God's book, the Bible, is full of promises from God, including our memory verse for the Holiday Club. Be strong and brave. Don't be afraid, because the Lord your God will be with you everywhere you go. We can count on God's promises. And although God never promises that life will always be easy, he does promise that he'll be with us everywhere we go, in good times and tough times. It's brilliant. He also promises that he'll never stop loving us. Now, to help us understand a bit more about all that, I think it's time we did something dangerous. And my puppets, Lou and Rolls, are going to help me with that. Let's do it.
You mean dangerous as in last year when I went horseback riding, upside down and back to front while drinking a can of Coca-Cola?
That does sound pretty dangerous, but no, let's do something else, slightly less dangerous than that, but something involving eggs. Okay, and I have some eggs here, and I'm going to take one of these eggs out in a second, but I'm going to use this one here actually first, because here I have an egg that's hard boiled. I'm going to put it on there. And here's a question for you. Is it possible for that egg to go straight into that flask without me or anyone else touching it?
No!
No? Possible or impossible?
Impossible.
Impossible. Well, let's see if it is actually impossible, because I'm going to try something now and we'll see if it will work. Here I have a bit of paper. Impressed by that? Yep. I've got a match, boys and girls. Don't play with matches at home. But what I'm going to do... Where did you go? Okay, let's strike the match and let's see if this is indeed possible or impossible. I'm going to set fire to this. Remember, boys and girls, don't play with matches or fire or anything because it is dangerous. I'm going to drop this in here and you watch what happens, guys. Put it on there. Yeah!
Wow!
It was possible!
So impossible!
I think that's worth a cheer. What do you think? Okay, now here's something else we're going to see if this is possible or impossible. I've got a whole load more eggs here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to see if I can get one of those eggs to go straight into this cup, okay, without, again, me touching it or anyone else touching it. So I'm going to pop that on there like that. Do you reckon it's possible or impossible?
Impossible, it's got to be.
Yeah, okay, well, we'll find out. But it is quite dangerous, and I'll tell you why it's quite dangerous.
Wait! More dangerous than that time I went swimming with dolphins and they weren't dolphins and they were sharks and I was underwater?
That was quite a long story, wasn't it? Okay, well, no. Oh, definitely not more dangerous than that.
But yeah.
Okay, but it is dangerous for you, Lou, of Rolls, try and get your name right, because when I hit this, this could come your way. In fact, the piece of cardboard definitely will come your way, but the egg could do too.
Ah!
Where did you go? It's crazy. Okay, should we do it?
Yeah, yeah, let's do it, Doug, Doug!
Okay,
do it!
Let's have a countdown.
100, 99, 98.
Oh, it's gonna take a week. No, let's count down from 5 and then we'll try it, but this could be dangerous, could come your way. Okay, so here we go. Ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Yeah! Possible, but shall we make it more dangerous?
Absolutely.
No!
Yeah, what do you mean no?
I mean yeah!
We'll make it more dangerous. We're going to take 2 of these. And we're going to see if we can do this with 2. Okay, so game, we're going to put this on here. I'm going to get a couple of these. Actually, do you recognise what these are?
Wait! Is that Mum? Mum, is that you?
They are Lou Rolls, but I don't think they're your mum somehow. Okay, now excuse me, I need to come over here. I just want to check they're roughly in the middle, which I think they are. Okay, we're going to put some eggs on top, and we're going to try it with 2 eggs. Is it possible or impossible?
Impossible!
We're going to find out now. Of course, this time, 2 eggs could come your way. Okay. Doing a very quick disappearing act. Let's do it. Let's do another countdown.
144.
Don't stop.
100.
No. Just stop. Don't do that again. Okay, so we're going to do it from 5. Ready? 5, 4. Down at home.
3, 2.
Where are you going? Go. Yeah.
Double the fun.
Woo!
Yeah, in fact, we could double the number of eggs. Should we do that?
Yeah.
Okay. I think that's a great idea.
We're going to have 4. Now, let me say, these eggs are not going to go wasted because we're going to use them. We'll make a meal, an omelette or something with them later.
I love omelette.
You love omelette? That's great. Now, somewhere around here are all the loo rolls. I don't know where they all went. I mean, there's one over here as well. So I need just to line these up. This is a little bit tricky. Let me just do that. There we go. That's about right, I think.
Your elbow was in my eyelash.
I can own it in your eyelash. That's an unusual place, isn't it? Okay. So nearly there. Oops. I have to get this very exact.
It's beautiful.
No, it's a good thing in there. Okay, so I think we're almost ready. I'm going to put the eggs on top, just like this. This is quite dangerous. There are four eggs and rolls. These could all come your way. Are you ready for that? Could anyone ever be ready for that? I don't know. Let me just double check. Yeah, I think we're about ready. We're going to do another countdown. Then should we try? Should we see if it's possible or impossible?
Let's do it.
All right, countdown with me.
200. 199.
No, not 200. What do you like? Really, we'll be here till next week. All right, we'll do it. We'll do it from four this time, just because it's a bit different. Are you ready? Here we go.
Four, three, two, one.
Go. Woo! Fantastic. Now, I want to tell you an awesome fact about eggs.
Tell us.
I will tell you, indeed. Now, eggs are obviously quite fragile. If you drop one, it will break. But something you may not know is they're actually super strong as well. And if you hold an egg like this, so put it in the palm of your hand and wrap your fingers all around it, completely around it as much as you can. If you put equal pressure on that egg and squeeze, it is really, really hard to break. Now, if you're super strong, you might be able to do it, but I can't. So amazing, eh? Eggs are super strong. And you know what? Something even more amazing than that, the fact that I can't break that egg, is that God's promises cannot be broken. And one of those promises is in the Bible. It says this: nothing can separate us from God's love.
That's brilliant.
It is. It's a promise that cannot be broken.
Awesomely awesome.
I hope you really enjoyed that, boys and girls. Now, I also hope you don't ever come face to face with a lion and have to wrestle it like David did. I'm joking. But listen, sometimes tough things do happen in our lives. And in those times, we need to trust that God will be with us and help us, just like David did. And the great thing is that we can talk to God about everything. So can I really encourage you to talk to God all the time, both when things are really good and also when things are not so good. And remember, He promises to love you and to be with you wherever you go. And His promises can never, ever be broken. David trusted God, and we need to too. Now here's a song of mine called God Can Do Anything. Do join in with the actions at home. And I'll see you again tomorrow. Bye for now. Let's go for it. Go for it, band. Play a little bit of guitar and then face your partner. Here we go.
God can do anything, anything at all. God can do anything, anything at all. Nothing is too big for Him and nothing is too small. God can do anything, anything
at all.
Don't put
Him in a box. Don't put Him in a box. Don't shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what He can do. Don't put Him in a box. Don't shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what He can do.
Let's go faster.
God can do anything, anything at all. God can do anything, anything at all. Nothing is too big for Him and nothing is too small. God can do anything, anything
faster.
At all.
Don't put Him in a box. Don't shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what He can do. Don't put Him in a box. Don't shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what
I
He
think
can
faster.
Do.
God can do anything, anything at all. God can do anything, anything at all. Nothing is too big for Him and nothing is too small. God can do anything, anything
faster.
At all.
Don't put Him in a box, don't shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what He can do. Don't put Him in a box, don't shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what
okay,
He can
really,
do.
Okay, really, really fast.
God can do anything, anything at all. God can do anything, anything at all. Nothing is too big for Him and nothing is too small. God can do anything, anything
put
at
him
all.
Box. Put Him in a box, don't shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what He can do. Don't put Him in a box, don't shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what He can do.
Give me a hand wave.
Yeah, yeah.
Bit of guitar, finish.
It's there somewhere. And then check this out.
Oh, suppose you think you're clever singing that fast. That's not fast. This is fast. Don't put Him in a box and shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what He can do. Don't put Him in a box and shove Him in a corner. Don't you limit what He can do. Yeah, yeah. Let's see you beat that thing, clever pants.
Well done, Gracie G. Woo!
ready for a challenge?
I am always ready for a challenge.
Okay, this is Jess versus Pip day one.
Day one challenge, okay.
Okay, I am challenging you to best of three strawberry lace race.
Oh, we have done these before. I've never been very good at these before.
So we'll have to just give it a try, we'll see, okay? So take your strawberry lace. If you haven't seen this before, guys, all that happens is you have a whole strawberry lace. You have to put it between your teeth and not touch it with your hands. And then on go, not before go, Jess, on go, you start eating without using your hands.
Okay.
And it is the first person to eat the whole strawberry lace.
I mean, they're very long.
They are quite long, aren't they?
Right. I'm ready. I'm ready. I can do this.
You ready? You'll put it between your
teeth. Are you going to count us in?
I'll count us in. Ready?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, go.
I know why I didn't win. I know what the problem was.
What was the problem?
I can only do this sort of thing if I'm getting lots of cheering and encouragement from people.
Oh, okay. Okay. Do you know my problem with strawberry lace races?
What?
I don't really like strawberry laces.
Ah!
Never mind. Have you got number two ready?
Yeah. So, but this time, can you all do some cheering in your homes for me? Can you shout and cheer
Hang on
and
a minute.
Encourage me?
Can they cheer for me as well?
We won.
Well.
Okay.
I've got to win two before I've won the competition.
You can decide. You can cheer for me or for Pip or for both of us at once. You could be like, Jip and Pest, whatever you want. But give us some encouragement.
Okay, we're gonna ready? We'll have another go. In between teeth, just the tip. Ready? Mm-hmm. 3, 2, 1, go.
Is these amazing juggling balls.
That is brilliant. I cannot wait to have a go at making some juggling balls later.
And maybe you can even try to learn some juggling.
That would be pretty cool.
Are you any good at juggling, Pip?
Not yet, but ask me tomorrow.
We will try that tomorrow and see how Pip has got along. And if you want to share with us what you've been up to, send us a picture of your craft or your puzzle sheet that you've got in your boxes as well. Or even send us a joke or a picture you've done and we will try and include them tomorrow.
It would be great to see some of your faces tomorrow morning as well. Thank you for being with us today. We're going to close it there, aren't we, Jess?
We will now go to our final song.
We will.
Because you can't end a holiday club day without singing our goodbye song. So get your hands ready because we're going to finish with an alligator snap. Goodbye.